Whatever you type in this box will show up as the ViewMark display name on the power-up screen and also an Ethernet browse box. That can make it real handy to ID a particular display. Let's type in shop floor and write the configuration out to the ViewMark. When that's done, the display will reset and you get a new power-up message that shows you the display name. This diagnostic LED option is great. When you enable that and write it out to the ViewMark, an LED in the lower left corner of the display will light up. Then, anytime you send a message, the color of the LED changes. So if I send this message several times, you can see it changes from green to red to amber back to green. That tells me a message was sent to the ViewMark. That can be real handy when you're trying to debug things. Speaking of blinking LEDs, you can test all the LEDs at once by clicking on this button. It lights every LED on the ViewMark all at the same time a couple of times. Note that since the amber color is really just the red and the green being turned on at the same time, you can also tell if the red or the green side of the LED is bad. If you click the heartbeat option, and oh, let's set that for 5 seconds for this example, and write it out to the ViewMark, then if the ViewMark doesn't receive a message within 5 seconds, it'll display this error message. Let's go ahead and send a message, and you can see we're back to normal. I'll keep sending a message once every couple seconds, as you can see by the diagnostic LED down at the bottom. But if I stop sending messages for 2, 1,000, 3, 1,000, 4, 1,000, 5, 1,000, then we get our error message. The ASCII reply option tells the ViewMark to send an ASCII reply each time it receives a message. You can then look for that when you send an ASCII message from your PLC to tell if the message got there okay. There's a really good example of how to use this in the Do More videos that focus on the ViewMark. ByteSwap and WordSwap allow you to match the configuration of your controller. Note that if you change either of these, you want to make sure you change them back here when you set up your communications link also. Displaying syntax errors is a great way to debug problems. When this is enabled in the ViewMark, and a ViewMark gets a string with a syntax error, it displays a message telling exactly where the issue is. For example, I intentionally deleted a little bracket. Because I enabled that syntax error option, when I send that bad message, look, the ViewMark tells me exactly where the issue is in the string. The ViewMark normally automatically inverts the message if the display is turned upside down. You can turn that off by selecting this option, and you can pick the orientation of that message. You can easily import and export display configurations. This allows you to bring in a display configuration that you like without having to redo all the options all over again. This is especially helpful if you're setting up a whole bunch of similar displays. You can quickly blink the LED display by clicking on this button right here. You can reboot the display right here, reset the display to factory defaults, and you can update the firmware. This dialog tells me what the current firmware is and allows me to go grab a firmware that I can update it with. Remember, ViewMark software and firmware updates are always free. You can get the latest from the Automation Direct website here under Downloads. And here is yet another way to blink the LED display. And finally, by selecting this, you can run a test that'll turn on every individual LED and LED color. You just hit Start, and a test starts running. When you're done, just hit Stop. One final note, when you do establish a link to your ViewMark, you can give that link a name and that'll appear in this list over here. That allows you to click on that link and bring it up quickly later, but there's an even quicker way to switch between links. This drop-down over here on the far right allows you to select any of the links from that window and quickly switch back and forth between them. Suppose you have one ViewMark hooked up to your Ethernet port and another one hooked up to your serial port. Well, you can switch back and forth between those very quickly just by using this drop-down and not having to go into that menu. Well, that ought to be enough to get you going. Please let us know if you need any help. Automation Direct's tech support is always free and only an email or a phone call away. ViewMark, cost-effective, industrial messaging made simple from Automation Direct.